Hey everybody, this is Dave Blair. I'm in the RUF RT12R track car at Silverstone. This is a fixed setup race. I qualified 7th out of 13, right in the middle. Nice. So it's a 30-minute race. Let's grid up. All right. I'm running in VR. I turn the steering wheel off so I can see the dashboard. I turn the driver off so my arms aren't in the way. Now everything just freaked out. Let me adjust the... Oh. Okay, that looks about right. Hate it when that happens. So I have a Samsung Odyssey headset. It has an inside-out tracking, and sometimes it loses its place, which is annoying. Like that. Oh my gosh, is this going to happen all night? I don't know. Does that look right? Why does this keep losing its tracking? I have no idea. Anyway. Yep. We're in the rough. It's fixed setup. I'm gonna turn that off. Turn that. Oh my gosh, why is this freaking out all of a sudden? My headset's moving around.
The air temp is 78 Fahrenheit. The track temp is 96 Fahrenheit. Alright, Dave, are you ready? Watch for the lights. Go!
Go, go, go.
On your right.
Oh, we got a spinner.
Clear right.
Whoa, whoa.
Car right. Three wide, you're in the middle. Clear all around.
Well, that was interesting. So I got an off track for that. Oh, this guy's coming in hot. Typical race start. Somebody said sorry.
Good start.
Alright. Head down. Let's get these tires warmed up. Let's go. So, looked like two of the guys that were faster than me got taken out. There. All right, let's just be gentle. This car does not like jerky motions on the accelerator or the brake. And the tires are still cold. It's funny that this car was a standing start. I would have thought, I would have thought it would have been a rolling start. Alright, let's see where we're at.
P5.
P5, alright. So if you hear that dog barking in the background, that's my Yorkie. His name is Leroy Jenkins, and he likes to bark. All right, let's just relax. We're in P5, which is pretty good for me in this car. Now this is season 2 of 2020.
Alright Dave, the next car is Nelson.
And this is week 3. So, I just bought this car for this season. And the first race was at Le Mans. And yeah, I know, some people say Le Mans, I say Le Mans, whatever. It's, that was the first race, and there were only 4 people that showed up in my first race, so it wasn't even official. But
the leader's just done a 203.7.
Because I was not ready for this car. I was not ready for that track either. I had to buy that track. So I bought this car in Le Mans. It was my first race. Luckily, it wasn't an official one because, again, I was not ready for this car or track combination. Most people that know me know I don't do any practice. I don't know any practice. I usually jump in on the car and track right before the race starts. You know, you have 30 minutes to go out and practice. That's about the extent of practice I do. So tonight for this track, I jumped in here with 30 minutes to go before the race. So that's all the practice I had here, and I felt pretty good. But again, I'm just trying to be gentle. I got somebody behind me 4.5 seconds, so I was doing 208s, 207s, and lap time practice. But I don't know if you guys saw, but somebody did a 203 qualifying lap here, which I'm like, where is that shortcut that you're getting 203? But whatever. Again, this is fixed setup car. Now I know there's certain places on this track you can extend farther than I do, but I don't know where the track limits are, so I try to keep it, you know, safely two tires on. At a minimum. Yeah, so basically this run is just going to be like, don't screw it up run. So I am thrilled with the P5. Felt like it wanted to come out from behind me.
The gap behind is now 4.3.
Guy in front of me got it together, it looks like. I'm not going to catch him. I would like to keep him in sight.
The car in front of us is Nelson.
I Everybody's really spread out. You'd think with these fixed setup races you'd have close racing, but not when you have people that can't control themselves on the first lap, spinning each other out. I mean, it's a 30-minute race. I don't know what the deal is. Uh-oh.
That lap was at 207.9.
Got the guy behind me catching up now. I'm messing up my shifts now. Almost like you're gonna put an egg under your shoe on the accelerator and brake on this one.
Minutes remaining. You've got 20 minutes left.
Next lap around, I'm not sure how many X's I got. I probably should have just had one for going off track, but I don't know. Why do I keep shifting to fifth there? I don't need fifth there.
That was a 207.5. That's your best lap in this session.
It's less than 3 seconds behind me now. Tires feel better, but I still...
Okay, Dave, the next car is Nelson.
I'm afraid to push this car. Alright, what do we got here? Push this car, it pushes back.
That's your quickest lap in this session. Sector 1 is 1.4 seconds off the pace. Sector 2 is 1.5 seconds off the pace. Sector 3 is 0.8 off the pace.
shouldn't have shifted to fifth there. Seconds behind me now.
The gap behind is now 2.2 seconds.
Thanks, Jim. Catches me, I'll have to let him go because he's faster than me. Plus, if I fight him, I might spin out and then fall back to last. I don't know. There's a lot to take into consideration.
Pitso is now leading. Fastest lap for Pitso, 203.1.
1.7 back, so. He's in my draft now.
Okay, Dave, 15 minutes left. That's 15 minutes. Halfway home, fuel's good. Your lap times are improving. This is good.
Maybe I should shift to fifth. There now. I don't know. That was weird. I never topped out the gear before. As Murphy is disconnected. I wonder if he was one of the ones that was involved in the wreck earlier on. I know I can extend that corner, but I don't know how far.
That's a new fastest lap for Pitso, 203.0.
The guy in front of me is only 5.5 seconds up now. He was 8. I meant to look to see how many X's I have.
Okay, Dave, keep it nice and smooth. Come on, let the race come to us. That's your best lap in the session.
I'm trying to keep it smooth. Ouch. No, 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 don't do that. I almost looped it. Oh man, Charles fell back now. He's 4 seconds behind me. All right, so let's
The gap behind has now decreased to 3.8.
I got 1x. I had to avoid that carnage in the beginning. Alright, we're gaining on the guy.
The guy in front is Nelson.
Not by much, but. Let's see what we can do.
You've got half your fuel left.
4 seconds up.
Okay, Dave. 10 minutes to go. That's 10 minutes left.
4 seconds behind me.
New fastest lap for Pizzo, 202.8.
Four seconds up. I think he knows that I'm eyeballing him. Smooth is fast. So 6-4.
Okay, Dave, the next car is Nelson.
That corner, it's like you want to get on the throttle, but if you do it too soon, it's a mistake. I don't know if we're going to catch this guy before the end, though.
That lap time was 206.2.
I am pushing a little bit harder than my comfort zone. Edward knows we're coming. Nice to get in this draft in this next long stretch, though. Still too far out.
Come on, head up. Keep your focus further down the track. Okay,
Dave.
5 minutes to go. 5 minutes left.
I am keeping my focus down the track.
Sectors 2 and 3 are 1.5 seconds off the pace. Sector 1 is 1.5 seconds off the pace. Good consistency. Keep them coming.
Seconds up. Oh my gosh. This car is getting so loose.
Push. We can get this guy.
I'm trying to push. My car's getting loose though. Ah, he pulled away from me. Dang, I should have been smooth through there. Could have been on him. This is so nerve-wracking. I mean, I am pushing to catch this guy, but time, 2 minutes.
Just done a 207.1.
Thank you.
Just 2 minutes left, 2 minutes to go.
So looks like we're going to have this lap. How do you go out that far? Looks like we're gonna have this lap and next lap.
The car in front is Nelson.
Oh, he went deep. 1.6. He's really pushing.
All right, Dave, you've got 10 minutes of fuel remaining.
I made a good run out of that corner and I didn't get it. It's 1.5 up. I think I'm still a little bit out of this draft. To go. I'd at least like to get up in this mirror.
One more lap to go.
Make him nervous. Dang. He's pulling away. All right, guys, I don't think I'm gonna catch him.
Filippi Enso.
He's leading the race.
Oh, well. Nope. Oh man, I almost lost it. All right. I knew that was it. I still wasn't gonna pass him, but.
2 minutes to go, 2 minutes.
All right, guys, fifth place finish.
P5, okay, that's the end. Good finish, mate, well done.
Good race, Edward. All right, fifth place. Let's hop out. So, results. So let's see what happened in that first lap. But yeah, 7th to 5th, not bad. Okay. Now that white and blue car really wanted the inside. You just cut over there in front of the orange car. Oh. And wouldn't you know it, that's the guy that spun the... All right, let's take a look at that one more time. So we're looking at Steve Owen here. He really wanted the inside corner. I bet you so he didn't get spun out. And then what does he do? Yeah. You should have never put your nose in there. I mean, granted, the yellow car did slow down, but... I mean, come on. It's the first corner of a 30-minute race. Guys, this is what not to do. Because not only that, this guy, Landon, you also ruined his race. All Yep. And that other blue car's race. It's just pointless. Steven Owen. There's our Edward Norton guy. He got, or no, Edward Nelson. He got by, and I followed him. But yeah, just, yeah. See, I had to go wide there. Wow, look at the cut he took. I'm sure he got a slowdown for that. I don't know. But that's just, man, that's just bad all the way around. So one more time. Again, the yellow and green car did hesitate a little bit, which caused him to swerve, but he was trying to make a pass. If he would have respected the yellow-green car a little more, that wouldn't have happened. So then those two collects. Let's see. Tom Wellink, he got collected in that. Let's see. Oh. Yeah, these guys made it through. So basically, three people had their race ruined. Yeah. Well, this Charles Kidder, he was the one that was coming up behind me. All right. Well, anyway. Tom Wellnick, did he start last? Yeah. No. Who started last? No, 13th. Marcus. Let's see. He started last. How did he make through here? And why is he going so slow? He must be expecting the carnage. Trying to play it. You know, he's out for safety rating. See, I've never been one of these guys. I go out and I race the race. Whatever happens, happens. I don't, you know, I don't race for safety rating. My safety rating is whatever it is I earn. Oh, this guy was causing all kinds of problems. Steven Owen. No wonder he quit out. Yeah. All right. Let's get out of here. I don't know if you guys can hear me. So we were in the top split. There was only one split. 15:34 strength of field with a gain of 20 in iRating and 0.16 in license. All right, thanks for watching.